Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Disney's Hollywood Studios welcomes you to, for the first time in forever, a Frozen sing-along celebration. Join in a fun storytelling and sing-along, capturing the best of Frozen moments. For the safety of others during our presentation, we ask you to refrain from smoking, eating, drinking, and flash photography. We encourage photos and recording, but please do not obstruct the view of those around you with your smart devices. And please, feel free to sing along at the top of your lungs. Thank you.
Oh, don't say that. It sounds like mom.
I didn't know that.
For the first time in forever, Elsa and I will be celebrating the Arendelle Festival. Hi, Anna.
I mean,
Princess Anna.
Princess Hi. Anna!
Oh, thank you. Now I'm honored to introduce to you the Royal Historians of Arendelle.
Okay! Hi, I'm Aria. Hello, everyone!
And
good afternoon. I am Sir Eric.
And when we're united.
I'm just Eric.
Uh-huh. Oh, well, thank you. Just Eric. And what better way to celebrate Arendelle than for the royal historians to share the story of our kingdom. Oh, and our queen, which just happens to be my sister, Queen Elsa.
Is she here?
I have been waiting for this moment for so long.
I don't know. Have any of you seen my sister? No. Well, she's about so tall. Gotta keep to herself. Oh yeah, she's these really weird icy snow powers. Pew pew!
Whoa!
No. Oh, I know. Hey, Elsa, do you wanna build a snowman?
Keep playing.
Oh, thanks. That usually never works. So. What I'm going to do? It's almost time for the Arendelle Festival, and Elsa's missing.
Yeah, okay,
princess. I never told you here.
Princess!
It's almost as bad as a blizzard.
Anna! Hey!
Hi. Listen, we've got this. You go find your sister, and we'll share the history of Arendelle.
We'll have them sing all the royal anthems.
Yeah.
Go ahead, don't worry.
Okay, yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah.
Well, I best be able to find my sister.
Hey.
Elsa!
Ready?
I was born ready.
Then let's do this. Citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land, we proudly present to you the story of Anna and Elsa. We also invite you to join us in the singing of the anthems of Arendelle. If you don't know the words, just follow along.
I got a feeling they already do.
Okay, where should we start?
Let it go, let it go.
Too soon. That's the big one. So, save it.
That's a good point. What were you thinking?
Where every good story starts, the beginning.
Right.
Okay.
It was a dark and stormy night. No, it wasn't.
'Twas the best of times. 'Twas the worst of times.
No, it wasn't.
Where should we start?
It was a beautiful day in the Kingdom of Arendelle.
And there were two sisters that loved each other very much.
Princess Anna and Princess Elsa.
Now, Princess Elsa was different. She was born with special powers.
Magical powers? She could create snow and ice, and Anna loved playing in her snow.
Until one night something terrible happened. Elsa created a monstrous snowman that rampaged through the mountain.
Are getting ahead of yourself again. This is when Elsa hits Anna with her powers and freezes her hip. Wait, what was the third one for?
You pulled me up on the dock.
Oh, okay.
And the king queen rushed on into the help of the trolls.
Oh.
And if you don't know what a troll is, consider yourself lucky. They're mischievous creatures with strange magic, and I've never been a fan since one of them rolled over my toe. I mean, really smushed it, is totally flat, like one tiny little flipper in there. I'm like a mer toe.
Oh,
staying focused.
Sorry.
Well, Grandpa be king of the trolls. He fixed on his head, but removed all memories of magic.
That's him.
Listen to me, Elsa. Your power will only grow. There is beauty in it. But also great danger. You must learn to control it. Fear will be your enemy.
They thought it best to hide Elsa's powers from Anna. And then the saddest thing happened.
No more snowmen?
No more snowmen.
Oh,
no way.
You really use a cathartic song?
Elsa? Do you wanna build a snowman? Come on, let's go and play. I never see you anymore. Come out the door, it's like you've gone away. And now we're not. I wish you would tell me why. Do you want to build a snowman? You're going to have to be a snowman.
Go away, Anna.
Okay, bye.
Do you want to build a snowman? Or ride our bike around the halls? I think some companies are. I've started talking to the pictures on the walls.
Hang in there, Joan.
It gets a little lonely, all these empty rooms, just watching the hours tick by. I'm scared. It's getting stronger.
Being upset only makes it worse. Calm down.
No, don't touch me. Please. I don't want to hurt you.
See you in 2 weeks. Do you have to go?
You'll be fine, Elsa.
Hey! What's going on?
I'll explain it later.
Where'd the mom go?
I said I'll explain it later. These people just got here, so they don't know what's happening.
What's going on?
It's really sad. Look, there's more.
They died?
Yes!
Well, what is this, Bambi?
No!
Lion King?
No!
Finding Nemo?
No!
I'm still recovering from the first 5 minutes of Up!
Wow, that was a cackle.
That's a really hearty laugh.
Man, it was sad.
Carl, he's a good guy. He was through a lot, but...
Yes.
This is sad.
Yes! But it propels Elsa toward her destiny and also forwards our story to the best day ever, Coronation Day!
Coronation Day!
Uh-huh.
Like all men, I love flowers.
Yay! Well, several years had passed, and it was finally time for Elsa to take the crown.
Elsa steals the crown.
No, she doesn't. Did you sleep through all of Arendelle History 101?
Okay, yes, but then my dad donated enough money for a new library, and they gave me an A anyway.
You're that kid?
What kid?
Never mind. Anyway, this is when Elsa becomes Queen of Arendelle.
What about her snowy powers?
Well, she was scared they would show and be cast out of the kingdom forever.
All the while, Anna was dreaming of the possibilities of opening the castle doors for the first time in... Yeah, it's Coronation Day.
What? It's Coronation Day. It's Coronation Day.
The window was open, so's that door. I didn't know they did that anymore. Who knew we owned 8,000 salad plates? For years I've roamed these empty halls. Why have a ballroom with no balls? Finally they're opening up the gates. There'll be actual real life people. It'll be totally strange. Wow, am I so ready for this change? But I'm
somewhere in that zone. Cause for the first time in forever, I won't be alone.
What's the love so long? Because when you know it, Princess Anna does meet someone tall, dark, and dreamy.
Who?
Who? Prince Hans of the Southern Isles. That's a hoo-hoo-hoo. Look, we're holding hands. We're on a date. I'm just going to get a salad because I don't want him to know that I eat. It's my thyroid. He understands. You get me. Look at you. Your teeth are so straight.
Boy, I could just watch you two talk all day.
Oh, yeah. Sweet.
Except I hate him.
What?
How do you trust that face? Look at it.
Oh, okay. You are just jealous because he's dreamy.
I am not jealous of that, and you said dreamy already.
And I'm going to say it again because the dude is dreamy, am I right? I'm sweating. I'm going to get you. You better run. You better run. I got my flats on, so I'm fast today. And when I do, I'm going to count your fingers. And get over here. A one, a two, a three, a four, a five, a six.
Hurry up.
10, 11, 12.
Conceal, don't feel. Look, Mom! No Hans!
Oh!
Don't forget, it's Coronation Day.
Oh, yes.
And the citizens of Arendelle and dignitaries from all over the kingdom have gathered for the royal coronation.
And Elsa was able to hide her powers and be sworn in as Queen of Arendelle.
And then they party!
Woo!
Boots and pants and boots and pants! Boots and pants and boots and pants!
And they had chocolate, the sister's favorite food.
I love chocolate.
Oh, me too.
But I can't eat a lot, you know, because I'm part Labrador. My vet said I can have some dark chocolate, so that's bittersweet. It was weird between us and Elsa. They didn't see each other much anymore, but they thought tonight maybe, just maybe, that would change.
And then Prince Hans came back and they danced the night away.
Hans, though!
Yes, Hans! Come on, don't you love true love?
I do, and that's not true love, because they just met.
You don't know much about love. As a wise woman once said, love is an open door.
Wise woman, she's a teenager.
Oh, come on.
I will never shut you up.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
I love crazy.
All my life has been a series of doors in my face. And then suddenly I bump into you.
I was thinking the same thing. Because, like, I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you,
I love my place.
I see your face, and it's nothing like I've ever known before. Love is an open door. Love is an open door. Love is an open door.
Each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I've never met someone who thinks so much like me. Jinx again. Our mental synchronization can't have but one explanation.
You
and I were just meant to be. Say goodbye
to the pain of the past.
We don't have to feel it anymore.
Love is an open door. Will you marry me?
Can I say something even crazier? Yes!
See? True love!
Hey! Uh-huh. Can I say something crazy?
Yes?
I think he needs more sideburns. Queen Elsa said, and I quote, "You can't marry a man you just met."
And this prince is honest, and I quote, "You can, if it's true love."
Okay. And none of this matters. Because everything's about to change, and it has nothing to do with true love.
Okay, well, Anna did push Elsa too far, causing her to throw ice all across the ballroom.
And everyone called her a witch!
Yes!
And a sorcerer!
Yes!
And she impaled someone!
No, she didn't.
Sorry.
Okay, now somebody's gonna trip on that.
No.
No, it's ice, he'll melt. It's a perfect crime.
Now she did manage to scare a lot of people.
Not as scared as she was. Despite Anna's pleading, Elsa raced across the tour and freezing it in the process.
Our queen froze our beautiful kingdom, sending it into a dark cult curse.
Nay, it was beyond cult.
John?
It was frozen!
Thing. There's a lot more snow in this story. Princess Anna, thinking this entire mess was her fault?
Which it was.
Went out into the blizzard to find her sister, which she did.
She did. She traveled all the way to the top of the North Mountain.
Ooh.
The top of the mountain, the ice king mountain.
Because you have arrived.
It's not necessary.
What's up, bud?
Well, Anna was wondering if you had seen Elsa. It's almost time for the Arendelle Festival.
You're all business. Not that I remember.
Yeah, I think we'd remember seeing the Queen of Arendelle.
Well, do me a favor and keep an eye out for her.
Rightio, Mr. Reindeer King.
It's just Kristoff.
Oh.
Hey, speaking of reindeer, where is Sven? We barely recognized you without him.
Yes! Is he going to make his entrance?
Well, he found himself some carrots.
Oh.
And you know, I couldn't help but overhear your story.
You know, we couldn't help but oversmell it. I know the troll said you're a bit of a fixer-upper, but you should be condemned.
That's the musk.
I kind of helped out a lot.
Oh.
Oh. Down
yeah, you want to come
okay,
on.
Yeah.
Without my help, Princess Otto would have never made it to the North Mountain.
Right.
Uh-huh. And not to mention, you liked her.
Liked her?
Well, was that your muscle?
Oh, wow.
Look at that.
That's great.
Weird. Hang
on. How are you? You're like two armadillos in a sack. Look at you.
That had anything to do with it. There was a blizzard with ice everywhere. And ice sell ice.
Yes!
See the problem?
No.
I had to help Anna to save my business.
You had to, is what you tell yourself, because you like her!
Yep.
I have to get back to Anna.
I knew it!
And find Elsa.
Oh my. I gotta get back to Anna. And what I do, I'm gonna help her find Elsa. But first of all, I'm gonna drink this protein shake, okay? Kristoff.
You know what?
He is dreamy too.
Are you?
Uh-huh.
Can I ask you something?
Sure.
You're throwing around a lot of dreamies today.
Uh-huh.
How come you never call me dreamy?
Because you dress like an elf.
That's not funny.
Children are laughing.
Well, don't laugh.
They're laughing at you.
Stop it.
Listen, it's getting louder.
Stop laughing. Stop it. Stop it.
They're pointing.
No, don't. No, you're just telling them to point. Don't point. Stop it.
She's pointing.
Stop it.
Stop it.
She's pointing.
Stop. You are a grown lady. Stop doing that. Yeah, I can wait.
Yeah.
Wow! Are you okay?
Well, not really. You threw me right under the sled on that one.
Did?
Yeah! You might not know this, but I have low elf esteem.
Okay. Back to the story! Princess Anna, with the help of Sven and Kristoff, started the long, cold journey toward the North Mountain. Now they navigate a deep and dark woods, where wolves attack their sled!
Werewolves!
Not werewolves. Just wolves.
Just regular four-legged wolves! And they lost Kristoff's newly lacquered sled in the process! It exploded?
Oh, yeah.
And it made that baby cry.
It did, it made it cry.
And so the party continued on foot.
Uh-huh. And then they came across this beautiful glen, and it was so romantic!
And that's where the real hero of our story enters. An awesome talking snowman named...
Oh. Yes! He loves warm hugs and summer!
And who likes summer? How can I love this guy?
Summer? Oh, I don't know why, but I've always loved the idea of summer and sun and all things hot.
Really?
I'm guessing you don't have much experience with heat.
Nope. But sometimes I like to close my eyes and imagine what it'd be like when summer does come. Bees will buzz, kids will blow dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. I drink in my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. I'll finally see a summer breeze blow away a winter storm, and find out what happens to soft water when it gets warm. And I can't wait to see what my buddies all think of me. Just imagine how much cooler I'll be in summer. The hot and the cold are both so intense. Put them together, it just makes sense. Winter's a good time to stay in and cuddle, but put me in summer and I'll be a happy snowman. When life gets rough, I like to hold on to my dream of relaxing in the summer sun, just letting off steam. Oh, the sky will be blue, and you guys will be there too, when I finally do what frozen things do in summer.
I'm gonna tell him.
Don't you dare.
Summertime.
It does. And speaking of time, we are running out of it.
Oh,
yeah, we've got to hurry up and finish this.
Speed it up.
Okay. Olaf, Anna, Sven, and Kristoff make their way up to Elsa's castle on the North Mountain.
Elsa sends Anna away, freezing her heart.
Accidentally.
When she learns of Arendelle's fate.
She sends Marshmallow after them, and Kristoff and Anna almost die jumping off of a cliff, but there was snow there to break their fall.
This is where we learn that Olaf has no skull and no bones.
I don't have a skull. Or bones.
Anna's hair starts to turn white, so Kristoff takes her to see the love expert.
That troll! Yeah, but it's too late. Anna's getting colder by the minute, and his grandpappy says,
only an act of true love can thaw a frozen heart.
He's British.
Yeah, he's a Rolling Stone.
So they race off to Arendelle to find Hans, so he can melt Anna's heart with true love's kiss. See, true love!
So while that was going on, Hans got a group of men together to capture Elsa. Not a cool move, too!
But Kristoff gets Anna to Hans, and he leans in to kiss her and save the day with...
He laughs in her face!
He laughs at her... Wait, what?
Yep.
Hans is the bad guy?
He leaves Anna in the room to freeze to death so he can take over the kingdom!
Hans is the bad guy!
Why? Just think there are no History 101?
No, I was just late a lot like those people! Well, Elsa escapes to prison,
bam!
And she's running across the fjord with Hans and Hopper still, and Olaf goes to Anna's rescue!
Olaf helps Anna realize that Kristoff and not Hans is her one true love!
Now Anna's out on the frozen fjord, and she is running towards Kristoff! Well, she's shuffling. And she sees Hans about to kill her sister, who has a migraine. Does she save herself? Does she save her sister? What to do?
What to do?
Oh, you get off of her.
My turn.
Kick.
Can't read this part.
We have to finish this.
Okay, okay.
Punch.
Olaf saves the day.
What?
Olaf stops Hans and he kisses Anna.
Go with it, okay?
That's right, the awesome talking snowman is the actor who loves his own frozen heart, and everyone lives happily ever after because some people are worth melting for! The end!
Woo! Thank you so much for letting me know.
Okay, thank you. Princess Anna.
Hi,
Kristoff.
Hello again.
So hello. Did you find your sister yet?
Well, we're still kind of looking for her.
Oh. What's going on?
It's getting cold in here. That can only mean one thing.
Oh, I hope so. Then we can really celebrate the Arendelle Festival.
The ending felt strange.
Thank you. Well, Olaf did help a lot.
Anna, you saved our whole kingdom. You saved your sister and yourself.
An act of true love will thaw a frozen heart.
You're my sister, Elsa. I love you.
Oh, wait, Elsa. I just have to let you know. The citizens of the Kingdom of Hollywood Land did a great job singing our anthems.
It's like they'd heard the songs before.
That's wonderful. You've all made Arendelle very proud. Woo!
Just around the
corner. Have a good one.
Thank you, you too.
Olaf looks forward to seeing you.